Welcome. Let's talk about the Down to Earth edition for this April. And here, first topic is Iron Ladies, where a group of self-help people have been working with the traditional occupation of iron, selling the goods through the Saras Mela, which is the sale of articles of rural artisans, and through the online platform. So these are locally made products known as Helans. There has been unseasonal rainfall, and this has impacted the price of food grain, mainly grapes, mangoes, onions, cumin, and wheat, because a lot of harvest ready crop was destroyed. Climate commitments, the small island developing nations, specifically Vanuatu, Antigua, Barbuda, are some of the ones which have been raising concerns to International Court of Justice, identifying and asking for accountability to the harm which has been caused to the climate. In US, there has been a vote clearing for lower energy cost bill. The bill aims to expand the domestic fuel production when the world is looking to shift from oil and gas. Now, this idea was introduced by the Republican Party. However, there have been repealing of the laws which have been passed for cutting the methane emissions to establish green funding initiatives. The next is tradition revival. Here, restoration of the pastures, dairy farmers coming back because of the inflation in the fodder prices, animal husbandry, which was so far profitable, being affected, are some of the major things that have been discussed. So Bhuj village is a case study which has been taken here. So here there are nearly 200 goats and sheep, and the fodder available is 52% of the households have to purchase them from the market in the peak summer price, summers which have the highest prices. Also, if we talk about the revival plan for the ecological security and the ability to resolve the fodder crisis, it has to be taken into immediate concern. There have been various saplings that have been planted to address this issue for neem, amla, khejri, mahua, and perennial native grasses like seran and bangati. There have been coincidences where numerous bird species have been classified with threatened by IUCN, and some of them are critically endangered. Four of them are in the category of endangered. There are various animals which have also been affected. Some of the most affected ones are in Uttarakhand. Various flowering plants are endemic to this region. Forest fires have been recurrent and affecting it. For example, taxus, which is a conifer, has anti-cancerous property, has been affected by forest fire. Similarly, asparagus, native to Himalayas, used for curing eye diseases, abdominal disorders, and skin diseases, has been affected. Stephania galbera, again used for fever, intestinal complaints, sleep disturbances. Xanthollum, used for toothache and allergy, are some of the crops which are affected because of forest fire. So what are the steps to minimize it? Collecting the fuel load at time for electricity generation, purchasing pine needle litter by the government is one of the ways. Fixing the fire line, creation of the fire line is delayed in the region of Uttarakhand. Installing fire wash towers, compensatory fodder which could be given to the livestock, ex situ conservation, which is moving these species out and conserving them, and the events across India, if we can see, when the temperature sees a little decline, then the events start to reduce. But this time, within January to March, we had nearly 5,000 cases of forest fires which were seen, which are significantly higher than before. And as you can see, as the heat wave spills, the number of forest fires increases significantly. Again, the animals which have been affected, the list of them have been mentioned here. Some of them are in endangered vulnerable schedule of the IUCN classification. The next is guavas. Guavas are native to Central America. India is as of now the biggest producer after mango, banana, and citrus fruits. Guavas have extremely high vitamin C, higher than citrus fruits. They are sometimes pale green in color, sometimes they are yellowish in color. Both of them have different taste. Now, there are three different periods. They are the Mrig Bahar, Hast Bahar, and Ambe Bahar, through which guavas are seen respectively in the month of November, March, and July. And then 90% of the flowers flowers of guava bearing fruit reaches 60% of the maturity. So winter crop is the most preferred crop. Allahabad has a unique variety known as Surkha Guava, which is pink on the outside as well as inside. It is, as I said, extremely rich in vitamin C, rich in beta carotene, lycopene, lutein and cryptoxanthin. Also, this fruit is known for pectin, which is used for preparing juice, jams and chutneys. There is cultivation which is done with spraying urea, root pruning, shoot pruning as some of the methods. The next is US is witnessing chronic poverty with this year, and there has been 12% of the population which is in deep poverty or extreme poverty. The data of Americans' dream has been withheld, with the fastest wealth creation and highest growing inequality. So less money for fighting poverty has been received, and this has been as per the Desmond analysis. Ocean deeps have been witnessing heat waves as such. So far we were only talking about the surface, which has been witnessing heat waves, but the studies have now shown that the subsurface and the deep ocean also witness heat waves. Plastic rocks have been found in Brazil, and that is because of the fishing nets which have been seen in one of the volcanic eruptions in East Brazil, in the Trinidad Island, and this has raised huge concern over conservation of animals. For example, conservation of endangered green turtles, which are seen in this area. Now, the second most exploited source after water is sand. Sand extraction from the river bed has been impacting the natural course of the river flow. It is not just one place. It has been seen with Ken Betwa in the Banda district, Son River in the Rohtas district, Yamunanagar district in Haryana, Katajod district in Cuttack, Narmada River, the Sehore district, Hooghly at the Hooghly district, Chambal River at Morena district. Those are some of the areas which have been affected because of excessive sand mining. The course of the river is changing. The ecological balance has been disturbing. So again, a very important cause of concern. Commercial interest and Antarctic areas being affected. Now, Russia is no longer engaged in krill fishes, but wants to keep this option open. There are new huge plans. So Russia has conducted geophysical surveys in East Antarctica. UK is proposing its first MPA in South Orkney Island Reserve at the Antarctic tip. Similarly, the second one is proposed at the Ross Island. No man's land, which was so far the Antarctica, has been given through the marine protected areas. 30% of the marine protected areas by 2030 is the international target for protecting the marine living resources in the region of Antarctica. Norway became the first country to set up around the Bolivar an area which was a natural reserve, and this is the Bolivar Island Reserve, which is by Norway. There have been Prince Edward by Africa, Crozat by France, Kangaroo by France. So this map shows the various marine protected areas across the region. Weddell Sea is again a proposed area. Domain 1 is another a proposed area being negotiated under this concept. So India is trying to gain attraction and getting to the Weddell Sea in the East Arctic to support the marine protected seas. The next is water crisis. 1 in 4 people globally have been affected by shortage of water. And in India, we are trying to provide water through the Jal Shakti Mission. We have the largest dam rehabilitation program of the world for restoration of groundwater. There have been various milestones for various conferences. The Stockholm conferences, the first in line from 1970s to 1980s, the important list of conferences we have jot down. And then in 1977, the first attempt to avoid water crisis for 20th century was tackled. European Union announced a pledge to support nearly 70 million individuals with better water facilities. Switzerland has been working with 5 commitments with UN on the same. However, there has been lack of ambition post the adoption of the water action agenda. Then the next topic is the displaced settlers in Kerala's Attapatti block. Here the villagers have been affected because the Suzlon windmill has been leased on the tribal land, and this tribal population accounts for 6% of the state's tribal population. So land has been encroached and there have been debates on the same. The next is public health vaccines being provided across the global figures. So in low income country, only 28% of the population received a single dose. However, we say minimum two doses are prescribed. WHO, which is the World Health Organization, would publish its first report on commercial determinants of health by a global conference soon. So there are three reports which would be prepared by Lancet Medical Journal. The first paper talks about the impact on the health, negative, positive, direct or indirect. The second paper talks about the responsible for how the healthcare industry has been responsible for the huge charges and incentivizing the doctors for costly unnecessary drugs, processes like hysterectomy, cesareans. The third paper talks about policy and governance that needs to be enframed. And then there is another topic, which is Forest Amendment Bill, which has been introduced in the Lok Sabha, seeking to change the India's forest conservation laws and exempt certain categories of land under the purview of the forest amendments. So Tamil Nadu organic farming policy has been rolled out by Tamil Nadu to facilitate chemical-free organic farming to conserve the soil health and agroecology. Some other important news, for example, Brunei declared its first polio outbreak in 30 years. UK has talked about net zero greenhouse gas emissions. We have the Right to Health Act, which was passed by the Rajasthan Assembly in March 2023. Cheetah brought from Kunu National Park from Namibia has made the first birth in India after 70 years. Sikkim Sokpai village witnessed a recent landslide because there was a dam project being taken by NPHC. There has been rising water levels and 90% of the salt marshes of the world are supposed to be submerged or reduced if this sea level rise continues. And finally, the General Secretary has talked about an International Day for Zero Waste to encourage prevention and minimization of waste in bringing in an effort for circular economy. So those were some of the topics that we have covered for today. Stay tuned for regular updates and summary from Down to Earth Yojana and Kurukshetra. Wish you good luck for the upcoming examination.